How do you distinguish between the emotional issues and the spiritual issues for patients who are facing the end of life?
They're very often overlapping. To me, a whole person is when you're in harmony between your physical, emotional, intellectual, and spiritual quadrant. And a lot of people don't like the word spiritual, so I say intuitive quadrant, which is really the same thing. I think I really learned a lot about the spiritual quadrant when I started to work with young children. Children who have either been raised without any religious background, or nobody really talks much about it, or they have been ill from a very, very young age on, never attended a church or a synagogue or anything. And I was very moved how 5-6-year-old children who have been ill maybe most of their lives and who have not had formal religious teachings are far more spiritual than children who have gone like to Sunday school every Sunday. And to me, it's a big difference between being religious and being spiritual. Mm-hmm. I think every human being is born with a spiritual quadrant, whether they use a religious denomination or belong to any official form of church teachings or not. That is like a gift to us mm-hmm. from God, that we are a part of that one God. And I noticed that children who have suffered a lot, not just terminally ill children, but children who grew up during a horrible war, like many children in Lebanon, Beirut, I've talked to them. They're very spiritual children, but they have always had to face death or bombing or mm-hmm. the death maybe of a dad or a brother or somebody. And dying children, the longer they're ill or perhaps the more they have suffered, it's like a compensatory gift that those children are receiving as their physical quadrant deteriorates. They develop their spiritual quadrant prematurely. Mm-hmm. You can have like an old wise soul, I call them. You mm-hmm. can have a 5-year-old child who's an old wise man. They may talk like a rabbi. Mm-hmm. I don't mean necessarily a Jewish rabbi, but like a teacher. Sure. In the body of a 5-year-old child that may look 3 years old. Mm-hmm. And that is a compensatory gift, and that is verified in my work many times. When we lose something, we always get something that is more precious.